Hi everyone, my name is Samip. Thanks to Reactify and Kiran for having me on this talk. Today I wanted to talk about component rendering optimization. I am doing this talk because a lot of people ask me how can I optimize my component and prevent unnecessary re-renders and so forth. So I wanted to actually quickly show how to do it, and the second is when to do it. So without any further ado, I will get into it. The first part, right, is actually using react.mimo. Basically, right, react.mimo is the same thing as pure function in when we were using more class components. We had this thing called react pure function. Basically, what react.mimo does, right, is actually it checks the previous props and current props. And if the props are not changed, it will not re-render the component. If that doesn't make sense, right, let us see with a live example. So for this purpose of this talk, right, I've done actually a very simple fruit dispenser where you can actually buy apples and oranges. We have two components in this fruit dispenser. First is the parent component, and inside the parent component, there is a child component. I'll share some quick code to actually make my talk more practical and actually more understandable. So basically, right, our parent component has two states for apples and oranges. Let's say the store has 10 apples currently, and people can buy from it. And we have another state for color. And we can go to the rendering part. And actually, basically, right, we are displaying the number of oranges that we have, number of apples we have. And then we have an option to actually buy orange from the parent component. Then there is a child component. And the child component, right, it's just actually rendering a simple line, which is saying this is a child component. And actually, there's a button to buy apples, but actually the state, right, is coming from the parent component. So with this context, right, let's start and understand how react.mimo works and why we should use it. So let us actually see this component and buy an orange. So as you can see, it's re-rendering the parent component, and actually the child component is not being re-rendered. But actually, as we know, when I buy an orange, the state of the parent component changes. And by right, when the state of the parent updates, all the children actually needs to re-render also. So why is this happening? It's because we have actually wrapped the child component with actually something called react.mimo. Okay, so with this, right, it will automatically compare the previous props and new props. And in this case, right, because the props have not changed for the child component, it will actually not re-render the child component. If I remove the react.mimo, right, and do the same thing again, right? Let's say I refresh the app and I remove all the warnings. And then we can see when we buy orange, we are actually re-rendering both the parent component and the child component. How we know this is by a simple console log in our component. Okay. So basically when I use react.mimo, right, basically, when I change only the parent components, by buying an orange, I'm only changing the parent state. The child component is not re-rendered. So this is one way, right, to actually prevent re-render for the child component. Of course, there is some caveats which we'll show into later. Okay, now let's say we actually have an additional thing whereby we actually need to pass some style to actually our component. So let's say our style is a simple object. If you can see the line 29, right? Our style is a simple object which is actually using some kind of color and actually some kind of font weight. So I'm passing the style to the child, and the child, right, is simply applying the style, okay, on this line. So when I pass the style, right, let's see what happens. Now I'm passing this prop. And now when I buy an orange, the state in the parent component changes, but the child component is again getting re-rendered, although we actually are using react.mimo in our actually child component. So why does this happen? Because just now we actually we said that actually when we're using react.mimo, if the props don't change, the component will not get re-rendered. So let's reassess our statement. Has the props changed? Has the only prop we are passing is style? Has the style prop changed? Actually, if you look at it like this, it seems like it hasn't changed. But let's see one thing. We go to the JavaScript console and we do actually equality check of an empty object with another empty object. And as you can see, this is saying it's not equal. The reason, right, is because object in JavaScript is a non-primitive type. And non-primitive type, right, are actually, when you triple equal to them, right, it's actually, the equality is by reference. So the reference means the position where this object is saved in memory and this position where this object is saved in memory is different. So actually that's why JavaScript is saying, oh, these are two different objects. So when we understand this, right, we can understand that when the parent component is re-rendered, right, this object itself, the reference for the object is going to be different for every re-render. Hence, the prop passed, which is this object only, is actually the reference is going to change. So for the child, right, the props is going to change. And like we know, if the prop changes, then of course, you know, even if you're using react.memo, props change means the component has to re-render. That's why the component is re-rendering. But just now we actually said that we want to use react.memo to prevent unnecessary re-renders, right? So how can we achieve this? So one way to achieve it is we just don't pass any props, but that's actually not a very smart solution because we need to pass props. So one way to do this is we can actually define the object outside our React component. Okay, then the reference will be actually maintained. So when I use this object, which is actually, I call it style outside React component, and I pass it as a prop and I save it and I just ignore all the warnings like everyone should not do. Okay, and I actually buy oranges. You can see actually that the child component is now not getting re-rendered because we don't see the console log. So how did we do this? By keeping the object or non-primitive outside the React component. But what if my color depended on my actually state, which is in the component, or it depended on some kind of props? What would I do in that situation? So that is when we can use this React hook called useMemo. Okay, so how does useMemo look like? So basically, like useMemo is a React hook. We can import it from React, as we have done here. It's one of the default React hooks available. And inside, right, I just pass actually a function with actually returning the object I want to actually return. And then the second argument for useMemo is actually a dependency array, similar to dependency arrays in useEffect or useLayoutEffect, useCallback, and so forth. So here, my dependency is on my color state. So only what I'm saying is only if my color state changes somehow in the app, only in that case will the reference for this actually, the calculation for this style should be updated. Otherwise, it will keep the same reference for this object, even when re-rendering. So let's see if this works. We actually pass the style as our prop now. And we comment the previous one out. And we refresh our app. And we buy orange. You see, actually, the child is not getting re-rendered because the object which we had, which was just a style, but what we actually want to show is actually this is an object. It can be actually any object, okay? I'm just using style for just a simple explanation. Any object, you're passing it as props because it's passed by reference. The reference will be updated on every re-render of the parent, causing the child to have updated props and causing the child to re-render. But when we use MIMO, it's actually memoizes, means caches the value of this object. The syntax actually takes a callback function where you return the object you want to memoize or any kind of primitive or non-primitive you want to memoize. And actually, because the style object is cached, when you pass it at a prop, right, until the dependency array is updated, so that means color state is updated, the reference will not be changed, the reference will be maintained. That's why the child will see the same reference as the style and the child will not re-render. So this is actually an example of using useMemo to actually memoize non-primitives like objects to prevent unnecessary re-renders in childs. Okay, now we go on to the third use case whereby we actually passing a function as a props. This is a very common pattern whereby we need to, let's say our parent has all the state and you know business logic, and our child component is a stateless component or a dumb component. in that case, we pass the method as a prop. Let's say we want to buy an apple. Okay, so I have this function to buy an apple, which actually basically just reduces the apple count one from the previous state of the apple count. So basically, it's just going to minus one, okay, the apple count. Now, let's see what happens when I actually pass the buy apple to my child component. The buy apple is actually received by the child component as a prop, and the buy, it's actually executed on the button click when I click on buy apple. So let's go back to the code and see what happens when I press buy apple. So as you can see, when I press the buy apple button, the number of apples is getting updated. Okay, so that's correct. But both the parent and child are getting re-rendered. The actually count for the apples is in the parent component. It's not in the child component. So by right, I actually do not need to re-render my child component because there is nothing in the child component that is getting changed, right? So if I wanted, I can optimize this child component to prevent the re-renderings. So how could I do that? So the way to do this is actually you need to memoize the buy apple method. And the way to do this is by using the use callback hook provided by React. So use callback you can import from React, as you can see on line one. And use callback also takes actually two arguments. First is the method that you want to actually memoize. In this case, we called it buy apple non-memoize, which is simply just updating the state of the apples, and a dependency array. The dependency array actually holds a variables, right, which are actually when they are changed, the reference for this buy apple is going to be updated. Till then, buy apple will actually refer to the same. It will actually refer to the same method. It will have the same reference, so that when the parent is re-rendered, actually the prop will not be actually updated. So now we are actually using the memoize method of buy apple, which is here, using use callback. And use callback allows us to memoize our original method so that every time the prop is passed, the reference for the original method is memoized, means cached, means is the same on every re-render until and unless one of the values in the dependency array changes. In this case, there is nothing in the dependency array. So what we're saying is actually don't change this reference anytime. And now let's see what happens when I save this and I actually try to buy an apple. So as you can see, when I buy apple now, the child component does not need to re-render. And this is our actually the expected behavior we wanted, because our child component does not have any actually, when you look at it, DOM updates when you buy apple, because the buy apple is rendered in the parent. So we actually do not need to re-render the child component anyway. So the way to do this is by actually wrapping the our actually function in a use callback. Okay. So now actually we have seen use memo, use callback, and react.memo. Now let's see actually when, now let's go to the most important question is actually when we should use actually these two, when we should use memo and use callback, when we should optimize our component or not and so forth. So let's do a simple experiment and actually remove all the optimization we did. Okay, we remove all the optimization we did. We are actually passing the non-memoized things inside, okay. Now I go back to my app. I actually buy orange. Now both are re-rendering, right? I buy apple, both the components are re-rendering, okay. Now let's actually inspect the DOM. So we go to our DOM. We open our app. Okay. So as you can see, this is the parent component and this is the child component. Now, when I buy an apple, if you look at the console, when I buy an apple, both parent and child are getting actually re-rendered. But when I look at the DOM, right, when I buy an apple, right, you can see the number of apples is getting updated in the DOM. Okay. Now we have negative 11 apples. So basically, they need to give us 12 apples. But even though the child component is getting re-rendered, you can see there is no updates in the DOM for the child component, which is here, if you can see my mouse. Okay, what does it mean? This means that actually, this means this reminds us of something simple, right? We tend to forget, at least I had forgotten, is actually React uses virtual DOM, right? Like we know, but re-rendering does not mean actually repainting the DOM, okay? Because on every update, actually React builds a virtual DOM, it diffs it with the old one, and then computes the minimal set of DOM mutation required to update the DOM. By DOM means actually the browser, document object model, okay? So that it, what it means is React is already optimizing all this for you. Even though the child component is getting re-rendered, it's not repainted again. So there is not much of a performance hit for the user who's using the app. What it means is React is actually built to actually re-render. Re-rendering is okay. And what we need to remember is re-rendering is not the same as updating the DOM. So we actually, to be very honest, right, now that I'm reaching the end of this talk, right, I'm going to tell you something is actually all the use memo and use callback that we use, right, and react.memo in this context in a very simple app. Actually, this is something called premature optimization. And in this context, it is not required. Basically, I'm actually asking you to not do the things I showed you. And the reason is because React is built to actually re-render. And re-rendering process in React is very highly optimized. It's batched. The updates are batched. Re-rendering does not always affect the DOM. So thing is, whenever you actually use something like react.memo, on every re-rendering, it actually has to compute the diff the previous props with the new props. It has to compare. And this computation, right, is also takes some of the resources. It's not free, right? So when should we actually re-render? Okay. A good way, use case for optimizing is actually when you have a large component. Let's say you have a list with a lot of items, with a lot of sub-components. So you really will see some performance upgrades by actually stopping unnecessary re-renderings. Then it's good to use actually react.memo, use callback and so forth. Or you know there is actually unnecessary re-renders in your app and it's actually affecting the performance. And actually there's a very good library called Why Did You Render, which you can use to actually check when this is happening. A bad use case for this is actually when you have a very, very small component or you're optimizing very prematurely. A good acronym for this is actually AHA. It stands for Avoid Hasty Abstraction. Also, it can be applied to avoid hasty optimization, you know? Basically, if you are, let's say you are working in a startup environment or you're building something new, you haven't even reached your first 1,000 users, you know, you don't have so many users in your app, there is actually optimization can be expensive. It creates some kind of extra code. It creates a little bit complexity to your code. And actually, it creates unnecessary diffing, checking, you know, on shoot component update. So in this case, right, a very good key to follow is unless you actually have a very big component, or you are actually getting some kind of performance hit due to repeated re-rendering, do not optimize prematurely in a very simple words. So actually that's the end of my very, very quick talk. I wanted to very quickly show, right, what is React hooks to and how we can use them to optimize our component to prevent unnecessary re-renders. Like I said, this is more useful for large components, or especially if you're working on enterprise projects, this actually becomes more useful. For smaller scale startup projects, maybe not so useful. We looked at three things. React.memo, if you're using class component, it's called pure component, is the same thing. It's used to automatically prevent re-renders if there is no props updated. It does this by checking the previous props with the current props and just stopping the re-render. The same logic, right? You can actually implement using the class component lifecycle method shoot component update. Second is we actually saw use memo, which is useful for passing non-primitive as props, like a style object, which doesn't often change. In that case, you can memoize it by using use memo. Third thing we saw is use callback to memoize functions passed as props, because functions are stored by reference, they're passed by reference. And even though the function is the same, on every re-render, the reference to that function may change, thus causing a re-render in the child component, even though you're using react.memo in your child component. In this case, you can actually wrap your parent, your function method in a use callback to actually memoize it. And last thing to remember is re-render does not equal to DOM update. Okay. So even though re-rendering is happening, doesn't mean your performance is really taking a hit or the user is seeing some kind of performance issue on his side, because the DOM is actually only updated after it actually diffs the DOM. By it, I mean after React sees the difference. And last but not the least, after sharing you all about optimization, actually what I'm saying is 90% of you don't need to use it because it might be too early. So it's good to know what is there, what tools are available, but actually smartness is in knowing when to use the tools available at your disposal. Yeah. So that's the end of my really quick talk. I think I went a little bit fast because I was afraid of time. But anyway, thanks for watching and thanks to Kiran for inviting. And if any questions, just ask me. I'm happy to answer. Thank you.